Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a RX3i analog output card I have here, an IC695ALG728. The ALG728 is an 8-channel current or voltage output module. So it's voltage anywhere from negative to positive 10 volts DC, or milliamps from 0 to 20 milliamp. Okay, current. So the first thing that I'm going to do is, after I've powered up the power supply, I check that the module OK light is blinking green. If I don't have a module OK light, then there's obviously a problem with the ALG card from the beginning. You'll also notice that I have my terminal block with the lever in the uprightmost position, which is showing that I'm physically connected to the actual terminals. Okay, this is a high density terminal strip. There's 36 screws on this. And the other thing is that you have a light that indicates field status. And what that's related to is what I have down here below. As you can see on my 18 and 36, I have two wires connected. One, the black one, is the negative lead from my 24 volt power supply. And the terminal number 36 is the red wire, which is the positive from my 24 volt DC power supply. Now, if you look at the wiring diagram, it's mandatory and required that you have this 24 volt power supply in order to test this module or use it in the field. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this power supply on. Okay, now my field status turns to green. That's another thing that you want to see before you start the test. Just these LEDs are a good user reference for you that the module is working okay or not. Alright, so far we know that this module has a terminal block that's connected properly and making contact. We have the field status indicates that our 24 volt DC power supply is accepted and the module is blinking green. So that's a good start. That's what you want to see. Next, if you go over to your software, I'm using Proficy Machine Edition. And I'm connected up to a new blank file featuring the processor I'm using. You use any processor for this test, but I just happen to be using a CPU 320. So I have my rack, which is open in my navigator bar here. And I'm going to want the same physical description in my configuration as you see in front of you in the camera. So using slots 0 and 1 is my power supply, PSA 040. Using slots 2 and 3 is my CPU, my processor. So the power supply and the processor use 4 slots total, leaving me with the next available slot of slot 4. Okay, so you can right click on that or double click, add module. This is an analog output. Okay, so you go to your analog output tab. And as I said before, this is an ALG728. Okay, 8-channel current voltage output. So we have to do some configurations. Before we start our configuration, first thing that you want to take note of is your reference address, because when we test this, you want to know where on the reference table we're going to start putting our values. All right, so I have analog output AQ00001. So just bear that in mind. I'll show you more about that in a minute. Go to channel 1. It's currently disabled. And we're going to start with voltage, which is the, as you can see, as soon as I went to voltage or current for this particular channel, it's giving me a range of negative 10 to positive 10 volts DC. That's the default. So we'll start with voltage, and we're going to use a 16-bit integer for this test. Okay? So again, we're going to enable the voltage and current and switch to 16-bit. Enable 16-bit. If you don't do this, the channel's not going to be working. Doesn't necessarily mean there's anything wrong with it. It just could be that your configuration is wrong. So make sure that you follow what I'm doing here. All right. Now, once you have all the channels set up and configured, and we're going to use the default values, We're going to want to connect up to the processor using the lightning bolt icon. Once it's connected, we're going to hit the toggle online mode. That's the green handprint. Now, if you look below, we're in programmer mode, stop faulted. Stop faulted means that the outputs are disabled. That's the stop part. And the faulted part means that the processor was handling a different task before this. Even if it's ever so slightly a different task, as long as there's one thing that's different, it will be faulted. And as you can see, my configuration is not equal. So because of that, we're going to go to target, online commands, clear. And we're going to clear that fault, the controller fault and IO fault tables. Select OK. And the reason we do that is so we don't get hung up when we download and run. All right, so download and run button on the underneath my arrow here, download information and run in one button. The first thing it's going to ask us is, what exactly do we want to download to the processor? This is just a simple test, so we're going to do hardware configuration in motion and logic. And select OK. There's no need to write anything to permanent flash memory or forced values or anything like that. We're just going to activate each channel, test that they're working, and then we'll be satisfied after we see the results. Okay, another thing to bear in mind as far as what you need for this test, because it's an output, you're going to need some sort of a device that is able to detect the power it's putting out. So I have a Fluke multimeter. I'm going to show you that right now. All right, and this multimeter is capable of testing voltage DC and current in milliamps, same DC. Okay, but now our output's enabled. And that's going to allow us to go over to our reference table. We want analog output. And we have 8 channels to work with. Okay. We want to put a value in every channel. Okay. All right, so here's what we're going to do. If you notice on the wiring diagram, each channel is comprised of 3 terminal screws. So for example, channel 1 is screws 19, 20, and 21. That's the top right-hand corner. And the reason that there's 3 screws is because when you're testing voltage, the common would be the bottommost screw, 21, and the voltage would be the topmost screw, 19. Okay? The middle screw is used only for testing milliamp. Okay? So keep that in mind. If you touch the wrong terminals, you're not going to get any type of value. All right, so for example, we're going to touch 19 and 21. And I'm looking for a voltage close to 10 volts positive DC as I can possibly get. Okay, which I do. It's kind of coming and going because my terminal screws aren't completely screwed. And you guys can always put your probes into the side of the unit itself. So I've got 10 volts DC. Okay, now what I would continue to do in this particular case is go all the way through every channel, all 8 channels, and make sure that each one has the 10 volts. So a couple of troubleshooting things with this is, if you probe the channels and your settings are so that you know you should be getting 10 volts, which means that if your scaling is set up so that 20,000 or 32,000 value in your output table per channel should yield 10 volts DC positive, then if you have anything less than that, there's likely a problem. Okay, just make sure that your scaling is right. The other issue, of course, is that if you could have an unstable circuit or an unstable channel, All right, that what means is that when you go to probe it, it's not a stable 10 volts. It might jump from 10 to 9 or 10 and a half or 9 and a half, and it won't settle on a particular voltage. You don't want that. That's a problem. Okay. Now we're going to stop the outputs. Go back to our ALG728 slot 4 and click on range, and we'll go for, you can go from 4 to 20 milliamp or 0 to 20 milliamp. It doesn't really matter, just as long as we test current in milliamp. Make sure that you get every channel. And then, same thing as before, we're asking it to do something slightly different. So if you follow my arrow down below, you'll see our configuration is no longer equal, not equal. All right, and that's because we're asking it to do a different task, milliamp now, in current. So we gotta go to clear, controller, and IO fault tables. Yes, back to download. Again, when it asks us to download, and what do we want to download to the controller, just configuration and motion and logic. Same procedure as before. What's going to be different this time is that we're going to ask our milliamp measuring device, my multimeter here, to check the values measured in milliamps DC. Okay, and then it's important that you select DC, because the typical default on most multimeters is AC, measuring milliamps in AC. So you need to make sure that it's DC, otherwise you will not get a reading. It doesn't necessarily mean there's something wrong with the card. Bear that in mind. All right, so I'm going to set up my multimeter for that. And of course, when I'm looking at the wiring diagram, I'm using the lowest most screw and the middle screw on my terminal strip. So when I go to, for example, channel 1, I'll be using 21 and 20, the two screws that are right next to each other. All right. Out of that channel, the three screws that are used, we're going to do the nearest most lower terminal strip screws. Okay. So I'm going to probe these. If you guys take a look at my multimeter when I probe these, I'm going to be again on channels, on screw terminal 20 and 21 related to channel 1. And I have a reading of 21 milliamps, 22 milliamps roughly. Okay. I am having some slight difficulty holding these probes on here. The one thing that you guys can do is screw the screws in on all the channels that are related. So that would be on the left-hand side, 1 through 12, and on the right-hand side, 19 through 30. If you screw the screws in really tight, then when you probe each channel on the screw, you're going to get a good solid reading. Okay, that's important that you do that. A little tedious and time-taking, but it gives you a more accurate value. Okay, so just as a recap, if you guys don't have a steady circuit, a circuit that gives you an output value that's stable and stays on a certain value without jumping all around, if the module OK light isn't on, or if it's red, that's a problem. If the field status when you turn on your 24 volt power supply is not working, it doesn't turn green, that's an issue. Something's wrong with the card. So. And of course, if you probe a channel and there's nothing there when you've put in a value and you have your processor in run mode with your configuration equal and your logic equal and the outputs are enabled and you should be getting a value and you're not, any of those things would be some sort of a catastrophic failure is what we would call it with the card, and it would need repair or replacement. All right, ALG728 is a module that we can repair here, and we do repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or you're interested in, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.